We are at Richard's Cafe in Whites Creek, Tennessee. This place has a lot of history for me. It's one of the first places I came to when I was just 17 years old, just moved to town. I don't know how I found this place, but I found out that they did live music, and I booked my first gig in Nashville here. This used to be the stage. He always had like a bunch of blankets hanging from the windows, and I think it's like almost like a patchwork quilt was up there when I performed for the first time. I'm wearing this sweater dress and this weird hat, and I'm just like a little baby playing my guitar right out there in front of the big window on the stage. And 10 years later, I'm walking in the door again at this place, but this time I'm asking Richard for a job. And yeah, I waited tables here for a few years and saved my tip money and funded the dream off working here. My hometown, Shoeyville, Iowa. It's just a tiny little town. It was the best place to grow up. There was not much live music where I come from, very like blue collar town. I didn't have a lot of exposure to music. The only thing I was really hearing was country radio. And I just decided I wanted to be in country music. It's just the strangest thing. And I remember my dad always kind of passively, we'd be in church or something, and he'd be like, well, you say you want to be a singer, but I don't hear you singing. You know, and he'd say things like that. Or I remember one time I was folding laundry in the laundry room, and he came in, he's like, how come you don't have any shows booked? And I'm like, I'm working on it. And he's like, well, you're not working hard enough. Get some shows booked. So he was kind of that influence for me that was like a little pushy into the deep end and you'll figure out how to swim. But after that, I started booking some shows, if only to prove him wrong. And I booked my first show. It was a bar in my little town. It was called Melsha's Tap. And the whole town showed up. It was just packed. And that was the one that I feel like I got the bug. I just wanted to be in it so bad. I would spend so many hours just in my bedroom with my guitar, you know, trying to learn songs and write new ones. And I would write my song lyrics just on my bedroom wall. And my mom booked a trip to Nashville. I was 15 years old. She booked us a night at the Grand Ole Opry. We're backstage and I see little Jimmy Dickens, and I like went up to him and I said, I'm Hailey Whitters, I'm gonna be in country music someday. And he said, well, you keep on saying that, baby, I believe it. And then he walks out on stage and I see the curtain go up and I saw the lights come up and I saw the crowd and I was like, that's it. This is what I'm going to do for the rest of my life. And after we got home from that trip, I was like, I'm moving to Nashville. When the day I graduate high school, I'm moving there, and that's what I did. Okay. I'm 12 years into a 10-year town, too far in to turn around, too old to go back to school, won't be much longer, I'll be old news, thought I'd be a big star now. I'm 12 years into a 10-year town. My first cut was a song called Low All Afternoon. I wrote it by myself and Martina McBride cut it. And then I put out a record called Black Sheep, and then she invited me out to go on tour with her, and I was opening on her Love Unleashed tour. And it was after Martina I'd had the Little Big Town cut. I had Happy People, but nothing about my path has been just fast and easy and a straight shot and so obvious. I've had to fight and grind and roll and, you know, and it's constantly been highs and lows for me, you know, and it'd been years again after Happy People, I just wasn't getting cuts. It was the timing of kind of that 10-year mark. And everyone's always said, Nashville's a 10-year town, it takes 10 years. And I was like, well, I'm here. It's year 10. I'm hearing all this no around me, all this rejection, and I'm watching, you know, my friends back home on their third kid, buying their houses, getting married. And I was having a really hard time just, you know, seeing both of those things and thinking like, what am I doing? And I decided I was gonna do one more record, kind of the last ditch attempt to try and get something going. If nothing happened with this record and I went home after that, I just wanted to create something that I was proud of that I felt like really showed my time here. And that was the Dream record. If it fails, it fails, but at least it's me. And so I think those years really just helped form me and helped shape me. Even still to this day, like coming back to this place, coming back to Richard's, there's still moments of just like, I can't believe this happened, you know? I remember announcing that I was playing Radio City Music Hall with Maren Morris when I had just quit my waitressing job that Monday. And by Friday night, I'm standing on the stage at Radio City Music Hall wearing, you know, a sparkly dress, no apron in sight, singing 10 Year Town to thousands of people. Like, little moments like that would just come along and you're just overwhelmed. I can't believe that it happened, you know, and that it's happening. It's been really cool.
I'm 12 years into a 10 year town.